How's it going, everybody? This is Carpo, and welcome to another episode of My Reality. I don't know what else to call it. This is the reality of life as I see it. So, I got my coffee, and I'm going to talk about bass. Bass. Why we love bass. I was listening to some, you know, electronic music over the weekend, and I was in one of those states of mind, let's just say, where I was a little more susceptible to making connections and awarenesses and having a certain deeper understanding of the roots of music. And I was discussing this with my son, and we're both musicians. We both play guitar, and over the years, you know, I've grown to appreciate the simplicity of music. And I've always enjoyed complex rhythms, complex beats, but there's something that's lost in it. And this is why I really loved heavy metal in the 80s and 90s, but when it expanded into like the extreme death metal, you know, realm, I couldn't do the heavy beats. And we had a drummer in my band that was really good, but he was just too much, too fast. And it brought me back to when I was about 18 or so, or maybe around there, and I was talking to somebody, and I can't remember who said it or if it was a quote from someone else, but they said it's not the music, or I should say, it's not the notes that move us or that make music wonderful. It's the space between them. I wish I could remember how it was put, because it wasn't wonderful, but the point being that it's the space between the notes that sets the tone. Now, things like dubstep, where you have a drop, or songs where you stop and then come right into it, you know, those kinds of things, that's anticipation, and that's what we're waiting for. We anticipate the next, let's just say, this is why a song has a format with a chorus, you know, and a repeatable chorus that may change a little bit, but that we can remember and repeat. But when it comes to the beat, it's a little more complex. I mean, we have guitar riffs, we have solos, we have, you know, the lyrics that fit their place, if there are lyrics in the music. But the beat is the root of the music. The beat is the beat, the natural rhythm that drives it. And a term I heard once was that the drummer is the bus and that the bassist drives the bus, something to that effect. I can't remember, it's been a while. But the bass is a big part too, the bass in the and the drums. So let's just move forward to drum and bass music, and what they call today deep house music. And I'll say my current favorite music is like deep house, I guess it would be deep house glitch trip hop. You can call it, I mean, there are a million different names, but there's a certain genre that really moves me. And I've been asking myself, why am I so in love with certain types of electronic music? Because I also love bands like Primus. And, you know, that's because Les Claypool was a phenomenal bassist, and I love bass. Now, I play bass, too. When I was 14 or 15, I got my first guitar and decided I thought my fingers were too big to play guitar, so I asked for a bass guitar because I had bought a crappy acoustic. But I got my first bass, and that's what I played. And I realized there was more to it than just having big fingers. It's just that I love the sound of bass. Now, out here in my little office, I've got a subwoofer hooked up, you know, to my little system in my little room, and sitting on the concrete floor, and I got it cranked up to 10, and I just love to feel the bass in my music. So anyway, on to why we love it. My son and I were discussing this very thing, and I said, you know, it's like, it comes from our ancient roots, obviously, tribal, you know, and I mentioned this to my son. I said, he's like, I think we were sitting there waiting for the burn, and he said, some particular music comes on that the DJ was playing, and I said, I love this stuff. It's tribal. And he's like, tribal? I was like, yeah. And he's like, well, tribal's like, you know, tribal, like drums, you know, like, and I kind of, you know, he was trying to get more out of what I was trying to say, and I said, basically, tribal music is played to define each tribe. Tribal music is all different. For our tribe, this is our tribal music. Electronic music has become the tribal music for things like Burning Man and other events like this, which kind of started with, you know, Burning Man and the rave scene, which were separate entities, but converged in this one great, I guess, you know, it's hard to describe. It's really hard to define. When you go in there and you listen to all these different DJs playing all this different these different types of music, and you go from camp to camp, I ask myself what drives certain music. Like one of my friend that I stay with, his name's DJ B Lit, and he does his own comp. He's about my age. He grew up in my generation, so he plays a lot of the same type of music. And he even did like a, you know, an electronic version of like, you know, Feel Like a Stranger from Grateful Dead. So, you know, everything from that to Led Zeppelin to modern stuff, Snoop Dogg, whatever you want, you know. He likes the same stuff I do. So he played, he plays this kind of glitchy tune, and I really was paying attention to the beats themselves. Now, why does frequency drive us so much? Beyond the drums themselves, which obviously hold the beat and give us something to dance to. I mean, that's what the beat is. The beat is the root of how we move. The bass is something completely different. And it's become more than just a tone or a frequency. It's become a feeling. When you can feel the bass, when you're standing in front of 24-inch huge monster Sermon Vega speakers, you know, just pumping out at full blast, and your whole body is shaking, it's like, it's unreal. When I was younger, before I could afford bass speakers or anything, I took a house speaker and hooked it up to my car with an amp, you know. Gradually, things like that became more affordable, and I always had my bass in my car really loud. Not so everybody else could hear it, but because I like to feel it. And as I got older, now I don't really do that so much. I don't turn up my music so loud in my car because I like to be able to focus. I guess that's kind of my quiet time, probably because it's noisier at home. But I've got such a passion for bass, deep bass. And I think somebody told me recently that we were talking about this, and they said that they fell in love with bass during an earthquake when they felt that low rumble. It was an interview I was watching with, I think, DeadMau5 or one of those, you know, DJs. But at any rate, between drum and bass, you can do just about anything. I mean, if you take one of those out, you can have like acoustic style songs, or, you know, you can have, listening to a band without a bassist is kind of difficult for me. So not only did the bass, you hear it, but you also feel it. And the drums, you hear it and you also feel it. And the guitar and singing, those things are more of, you know, higher pitched sounds, which we don't tend to feel as much. So without the bass, we're kind of lacking in that. But it's kind of an amazing thing to watch groups of people all gathered around and dancing and having a good time listening to songs that they may not even know, because they're not there for the band or a particular song or album. They're there for an all around variety of music in which the bass and the drums have to be tight, have to be strong. I don't know. I guess that's my ramble about drum and bass. I just love it. I would consider myself what they would call a bass head. I've always been fascinated with shaking things up, but some people aren't. Some people don't have, you know, it's always amazed me that people that have like these huge television sets, you know, and they watch these really awesome hype, you know, action-packed movies, and they watch the movies or listen to their music through the television speakers. And so many people do this, and it's always amazed me. You know, I have mine running through these big-ass Sansuis. I have, like, you know, I like to hear and feel the movies or the music that I'm listening to. So when you're listening to, like, an MP3 on your phone, I mean, to me it's not even worth it. I can't even enjoy music if I can't hear the bass and feel it. So there's an exception. If you know the song well and you can't quite hear the bass and you can't quite hear the, you know, even if you can't hear the song very well, sometimes your brain will fill in those other instruments. I'm sure that all of you have heard a song come on that you know, and you can barely hear it. And so you're kind of singing along in your head because you can hear the beat. But when you actually get closer and hear the tone, you realize that you're not even in the right octave. You're not even in the right tone. You're like, and the tone's like, I don't know. It's hard to explain, I guess, but our brains are very, very good at filling things in. And this is why MP3s are, people don't realize that. I believe an MP3 you lose up to 90% in that compressed format, up to 90% of the original music. And it knows how to remove the parts that you may not even hear or notice are gone. But that's because your brain can fill in the blanks. This is why people deal with lossless formats like FLAC and, you know, whatnot. But MP3s, no good for me. I don't like them. I like my records. So that's my ramble. I'm out.